हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई एम युगल भैसारे, लेक्चरर एट मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट इन एनआईटी पॉलिटेक्निक नागपुर। इन प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट सम बेसिक इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग ग्राफिक्स एंड डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ लाइंस दैट वी हैव टू यूज इन इंजीनियरिंग ग्राफिक्स। इन टूडेज सेशन वी विल डिस्कस अनदर डिफरेंट बेसिक्स ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग ग्राफिक्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट them one by one. Let's discuss first the learning outcomes. After completion of this session, we will able to define dimensioning, use IS standard codes for the dimensioning, use upscaling. So let's start first. Now the question arises, what is dimensioning? The expression of details in terms of numerical values regarding distance between the surface, etc. If you want to give a dimension for a distance or anything, like if you want to define a diameter, if you want to define a distance, or if you want to define a grade, this all should comes under the dimensioning. On the drawings, by the use of lines, symbols and their units called as dimensioning. Some lines, some representation fractions, some symbols, they all are the units of dimensions. Let's discuss the general principle of dimensioning. We will discuss this with the help of this diagram which is present over here. First, all the dimensions should be detailed drawing. If you want to give dimensions to the drawing, it should be detailed. सारे के सारे डायमेंशन प्रॉपर डिटेल में देना आवश्यक है. डोंट मिस एनी डिटेल इन द ड्रॉइंग. सेकेंड, नो सिंगल डायमेंशन शुड बी रिपीटेड. मीन्स कोई भी डायमेंशन रिपीट नहीं होना चाहिए. अगर आप इस डायग्राम में देख रहे हो तो कोई भी लाइन का डायमेंशन रिपीट नहीं हो रहा है. ओके, नेक्स्ट, मार्क द डायमेंशंस आउटसाइड द ड्राइंग एज फार एज पॉसिबल. सी इन दिस डायग्राम ऑल द डायमेंशंस आर मार्क आउटसाइड द डायग्राम. सारे के सारे डायमेंशंस ड्राइंग के बाहर दिए गए हैं. कोई भी डायमेंशन ड्राइंग के अंदर नहीं देना है. Avoid the dimensioning to the hidden lines wherever possible. About the hidden lines, we have discussed in the previous session. So, avoid the dimensioning to hidden lines. Last is, the longer dimension should be placed outside all the intermediate dimensions. See in this diagram, जो longer dimensions है, जैसे यहाँ पे 60 दिया है, ये 60 बड़ा डायमेंशन है एज कम्पेयर टू 16 एंड 28. सो इसे हम बाहर प्लेस करेंगे. सिमिलरली यहाँ पर 50 जो डायमेंशन दिया है, इसे भी हम थोड़ा बाहर प्लेस करेंगे इन छोटे डायमेंशन से. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज द डायमेंशनिंग मेथड्स. देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ डायमेंशनिंग मेथड्स. फर्स्ट इज यूनिडायरेक्शनल मेथड. इन यूनिडायरेक्शनल मेथड all the dimensions should be given from the bottom edge. In this diagram you find that all the dimensions are placed according to the bottom edge and these dimensions are written at the middle of the line. This technique is very commonly used in all the cases. The next is align method. In this diagram all the dimensions are placed above the line. देखिए यहाँ पर सारे dimensions line के ऊपर दिए गए हैं. यहाँ पे middle में दिया गया था. And the next is, अगर आपको horizontal line का dimension देना है तो आपको horizontal line से parallel dimension line बनानी होगी and then उसके ऊपर dimension लिखना होगा. And if vertical line को dimension देना है तो vertical line से parallel line बनानी होगी और उसके अकॉर्डिंग यहाँ पे डायमेंशन लिखना होगा. vertically. This all are readable from the bottom and the right edge of the sheet. Next is the arrowheads. There are three types of arrowheads. First is open, second is closed, and third is closed and filled. Let us discuss them about one by one. See, in this diagram, this is the open arrowheads. We all are familiar about this from the teenage or from childhood. We all are giving arrowheads like this. The second is the closed arrowhead. Here we make a triangle over here. And the last is closed and filled arrowheads. We will use this type of arrowheads in the engineering. But there are some techniques to draw the arrowheads. I have observed that some students made arrow very large in dimension or some are in very small dimension. There are some techniques. See, in this diagram, it is the width of the arrowhead and this is the length of arrowheads. The minimum dimension of angle should be 15 to 90 degree. Take a note that the length to width ratio should be 3:1. जो लेंथ है और उसकी विड्थ है उसका रेशियो कितना होना चाहिए 3:1. सी आई हैव मेड अ फ्री हैंड स्केच ड्राइंग. मैंने आपको डायमेंशनिंग दिखाने के लिए एक फ्री हैंड स्केच ड्राइंग बनाई है. यहाँ पे देखिए मेरे एरोहेड्स कंप्लीटली फील्ड है हर जगह पर. डायमेंशन दिखाने के लिए मैंने यहाँ पे एक्सटेंशन लाइंस बनाई है. एंड देखिए जो छोटा डायमेंशन है मैंने पहले लिखा, जो बड़ा डायमेंशन है उसे मैंने बाद में लिखा. सर्कल को मुझे अगर डायमेंशन करना है तो मैं सबसे पहले यहाँ पे लीडर लाइन बनाऊंगा, देन उसको स्ट्रेट कर दूंगा. अगर मुझे सर्कल का डायामीटर लिखना है तो मैं वहाँ पे लिखूंगा 5 10. 10 का मतलब इसका डायमेंशन है, 5 मीन्स डायामीटर. अगर आपको रेडियस शो करना है तो रेडियस के लिए R05, रेडियस 5 mm. ओके, दिस डैश डॉट लाइन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, इट इज अ हिडन लाइन, सॉरी इट इज अ सेंटर लाइन. ओके, द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज स्केलिंग. सो व्हाट इज स्केलिंग? द ड्रॉइंग दैट शोज रियल ऑब्जेक्ट विथ एक्यूरेट साइज reduced for enlarged by a certain amount is called as scaling. If you want to draw a drawing, this should be in reduced dimension or in enlarged dimension or in same dimension. See this figure. Figure shows the accurate size of the dimension. यहाँ पे एक box बनाया गया है जिसका dimension है 50 by 50. So you can easily make this box. You can use your scale, draw a horizontal line of 5 cm and a vertical line of 5 cm. So you use the given dimensions and made these dimensions. It means you are using full scale. The ratio should be 1:1. 1 is given and you have made in 1. Now in the next, you have given to draw this house. The size of the house is so large that you are unable to draw this in your sheet. So you have to reduce this dimension so that it will easily visible in your sheet. So this type of scaling is called as reduced scaling. See, I have written over here 1:2. It means I have reduced this size by half. The next, if you want to draw these parts of the watches, we all are familiar that the parts of watch are so small that we cannot able to watch them from your naked eyes. So you have to enlarge the size of the dimension of the watch. So if you are enlarging the dimensions of the drawing, then this type of scaling is called as enlarged scale. I have written over here 10 is to 1. It means I enlarge the dimension of the diagram by 10 times. So these all are represented by a fraction. It is known as representative fraction. Representative fraction is the ratio of the size of element in the drawing to the size of same element is called as representative fraction. It is represented by R dot F dot. Representative fraction equals to drawing size to the original size. For full scale, we will take 1 is to 1 scale. It means your drawing size is 1 and you are make your original size also 1. For reduced scale, your drawing size given as 1, but your original size is more than 1. Means the size of your given diagram is more, but you make this in reduced scale. Last is enlarged scale. Your original size is given as 1, but your drawing size is more than 1. Means you are enlarging this drawing. I hope you all are enjoy this session. So that's all from today's point of view. Thank you.